back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we have a brand new style video for you guys. And I want to know down in the comment section below, do you guys enjoy the ones where I'm in front of the camera kind of breaking things down and going, you know, thing by thing as we do these top fives of these random things? Or do you like it in the classic spot? Or do you like it where it's just a voiceover with graphics and things of that nature? I plan on doing the front face camera and then integrating graphics and stuff like that so you guys can kind of see what I'm talking about. And just kind of mix and match here. And you guys can let me know down below what you guys think. But today, guys, we're diving into the Ultimate Edition action figures. If you guys don't know what the Ultimate Edition line is, it is the, you know, the more accessories, the interchangeability, all the, it's the $30 elites, basically. I mean, that's pretty much what they are, right? But I figured today would be a really good video to dive into five Ultimates that I would like to see from Mattel. Now, these are not, I don't know, you may agree with me, you may disagree with me, but let's go ahead and dive in, guys. I got five Ultimate Edition WWE action figures that I would like to see, and let's just go ahead and run through my list, shall we? Now, coming again, these are not in any particular order, so it's not like I want this one more than anything in the world. I mean, if I spent more time on it, maybe, but let's just dive into the list. You guys let me know what you think down below, and let me know if you guys would buy these or not, and let me know what your dream list would be. Starting out at the top, guys, I'm going with Seth freaking Rollins. I'm actually really shocked that we haven't seen a Seth Rollins just yet, but for me, I would pick between two different gears. I would go between WrestleMania 36, where he took on Kevin Owens, you know, and the Messiah, he'd have, you know, the white gear, or I would select the Thanos gear that we never got. Everybody knows the Thanos gear, should have won the fan takeover poll. I'm over it.
I said I'm over it.
I don't think we're over it, but everybody knows that that would be one of the gears that I would want. You know, you got the Thanos gear and you got the WrestleMania 36. If I went with the WrestleMania 36 gear, I would select a few things, okay? First of all, I would have the Man Bun head sculpt that we got with the Elite 86 or a new one, you know, at the time of release. I would say give us the Elite 86 head sculpt with the hair up, and then I would say give us the version with the hair down. Maybe a newer one would be nice, but I would take the older one as well. And I would give us like a more like angry, like kind of like the Elite 52, but not with the mouth open, if that makes sense. So kind of like, you know, just a pissed off head sculpt or something like that. Or the big smiley face one that, you know, the Messiah likes to do. So that would be our three interchangeable head sculpts. We'd also get the nice white throw thingy or whatever you want to say. You know, the nice little, I don't even know what you'd call that, a little robe entrance piece there. The gear would be detailed. He'd probably end up with the damn HBK torso, which would be garbage, but he'd have the nice double jointed arms. Butterfly joints would be appreciated. It would be a beautiful looking figure. You could even have like the off-white and the white designs going down. And then the Thanos gear, I would say do whatever we can to make that piece, that entrance vest, as nice as possible. You could have all the different things. Same thing goes for like interchangeable hands would be the same and stuff. And you know, it would just be really nice to see the double jointed arms and butterfly joints on that Thanos gear figure. And then, you know, they could go all out with the gold and stuff like that and the print and everything, and just really try to nail that entrance gear. Give us the interchangeable hands. Give us some sick ass interchangeable heads. That would be a very nice Ultimate Edition. Now, moving forward, guys, coming in at number two, I have Roman Reigns. Now, I think this is inevitable. I think we are going to get a Roman Reigns. I'd be willing to bet a bag on that one, Brad. I think Roman Reigns is definitely coming soon. I think that would probably give us two different options, right? So you would have like his current gimmick with the gold gauntlet, but maybe they could give you an option to interchange the gauntlets, maybe come with a black, you know, one black hand and a black gauntlet to go along with your gold interchangeable hands and gold gauntlet. That way you could do a classic Roman and a current day Roman. It could come with the, you know, like the lay that he has, like the crowning lay and the red. You would have a man bun head sculpt, a hair down head sculpt. I would really like to see an updated yelling slash pissed face, kind of like his old basic figure that we saw in the past. That would be really cool as well. Universal Championship, I mean, you could load this guy up and he could have a vest, like one of his better vests. You could throw that in there. That way you could, again, you could do his older look and you could do his new look. I think that would be really sick to kind of give you a two-in-one figure for Roman Reigns. So, interchangeable fists, you could give him the hang loose hands, you could give him the mic holding hands, slash, and of course you gotta have your fist for your Superman punch. So there you go. The number two is Roman Reigns. We got Rollins, we got Reigns. Number three is going to be The Undertaker. I cannot believe we don't have an Undertaker just yet, to be honest with you. I mean, I think that was one of the ones that I thought for sure we'd have an Undertaker by now. Like, I know we're getting one, I think, in Series 10, or is it 11? It's either 10 or 11. I think Kane and Undertaker are both getting an Ultimate Edition in the same wave, but I would go for like a mid-2000s look, around 2004, 2005. I would like to see him in maybe like his WrestleMania 20 gear would be really cool. You could come with a few different head sculpts, really nail that true effects. He could have the tongue out head sculpt. He could have have like the eyes roll back in the head, but he's like pissed, not the tongue out. So give us four different head sculpts doing that. You could have the coat, which would be beautiful. Of course, you gotta have the hat, interchangeable hands. And if you want to, you could throw in a world championship maybe if you wanted to. Or you don't have to do that. I don't know. If it's WrestleMania 20, not necessarily a world championship, but you know, it could just be one of those things you throw in there. They like to mix and match timelines and events and stuff together anyway. So they'd probably do that anyway. But that is something I'd really like to see for the Undertaker is an Ultimate Edition figure. And again, I can't believe we don't have that yet. It's kind of wild. Coming to number four, guys, I'm going to go with Randy Orton. How do we not have an Ultimate Edition Randy Orton? I know that it kind of seems like the Ultimate Edition line, like when we first started, it was really good, right? We had freaking, you know, one current and one classic superstar, like a big time superstar now, a big time superstar back in the day. And now they've kind of gotten away from that. They're re-releasing people. We're getting guys that we've already gotten. And I think Ultimate Warrior is going to end up with like three of those hoes or something, or Hulk Hogan, which I guess makes sense, but I would really like to see some new talent before we get, you know, re-releases of guys. So I'm going with Randy Orton. I think you could do a lot of different things. I think for gear, I would go with either this past year's WrestleMania in the white, or I would go with WrestleMania 31 where he took on Seth Rollins. I think a cloth hoodie would be really badass. You know, just a nice cloth hoodie vest that with like a bendy wire in the hood, that would be really sick, you know, for posability, so it wouldn't, you know, like be flailing and all up in here. It would be really nice. One thing I thought about was you could do like interchangeable arms where you could have like a Legend Killer look and then a current day look, but then I started thinking he has tattoos that go up on his shoulders and then he has the rib tattoo, so it wouldn't necessarily work. I don't know. I'd say ditch that idea, release one or the other. I'd take an Ultimate Edition Randy Orton and the Legend Killer though. Like if you went like 2004 Backlash, could come with a trash can or something with the Evolution shirt and the red gear. You could do a lot of stuff, man, but besides that, we could get a pissed off Orton face, a yelling stupid face. You could have, you know, the smirk face. I mean, there's so many different looks for Randy Orton that you could do. So Randy Orton would be a really fun Ultimate Edition as far as I'm concerned. If he was on ball joints and could do all the different posability, double jointed arms, that'd be a sick ass figure. I would absolutely buy a few of those. I may even buy a mock one to see that happen. So Randy Orton is next on my list. And coming in at number five, I think this is one that a lot of people really want to see. I'm going to go with AJ Styles, WrestleMania 32. Yes, ma'am. The match versus Chris Jericho. We got our match with Shane McMahon, right? We got a WrestleMania 33 gear, but his debut at WrestleMania, I know he lost, but how beautiful would it be to be in the white and red gear? We've never gotten a red gear AJ Styles Elite besides its SummerSlam one, but it was mainly black anyways. We need a red gear AJ Styles. You can give him the shorter hair when he first arrived. You can give him a longer hair. You can give him a pissed off face. You can give him a grinning face. I don't care. You can get creative with the head sculpts, but please God, give us a white gear, or I know we got a white gear AJ Styles Elite, but we really need a red gear. I think that'd be perfect. WrestleMania 32, you could do a really nice torso. If they released a double jointed arm, cloth, nice vest AJ Styles, I don't think I'd ever buy another one, man. I would just use that one as my complete AJ. The torso would probably look a little bit better as well. You know, I don't know. I just, AJ Styles Elites, like, are some of the most disappointing figures because, like, the torso has never sat right with me in my spirit. So I just, you know, I'm not a big AJ Styles Elite fan, but they could really fix it. If they fixed it up, could give them different gloves. I mean, dude, it would be a really sick AJ Styles, and that would be beautiful to see. And that is my last Ultimate Edition that I would really like to see. But down below, guys, let me know what you think of my list, as well as letting me know what your dream list is for Ultimate Editions. Would you buy any of mine? Running through it real quick, Seth Rollins, Roman Reigns, Undertaker, Randy Orton, and AJ Styles. I wanted to do some Legends, but then I got to thinking, I was like, dude, we have The Rock, we have Stone Cold, we have, you know, Jeff Hardy, who's not technically Flashback, but you have Hulk Hogan, Ultimate Warrior, Macho Man. Like, we have a lot of different guys, so I tried to keep it more updated, and then we have a couple of legends here and there. Undertaker, Randy Orton are pretty much legends, so Undertaker is obviously a legend, and then Randy Orton is a legend and in his own right. So let me know what you think of that down in the comment section below, guys. But before we get out of here, let's get into our random shout out. And our shout out today is actually going to go to Garrett_WWE. We let him breathe casually as AEW figs inbox behind him. Yes, Brad, right there, I see them, okay? But that's like the only little mock collection I have. I have a few WWE elites behind these, but for the most part, man, I am not a mock collector. If you look around this room, I mean, there is thousands of figures that are not in box. I don't collect mock except for AEW and a few special WWE things, so there you go. But I thought that was a funny comment by Garrett, because I literally said, we let him breathe around here as like 60 AEW figures or so are freaking just, you know, banging on the damn plastic to get out of there. But you're not getting out of there, Brad. Don't cross it. You crossed the line. I've been